Hey guys, welcome. It's Martin from Yes, I'm a Designer. Today I will show you a new feature of Adobe Illustrator CC 2019. So here's an example of a complex Illustrator project with lots of artboards and a lot of different variations of the same artwork. So I worked on a project recently and I designed these labels for products. So they are coconut butters and all kinds of different variations of that. I needed to create lots of different sizes and lots of different versions based on the flavors, and all of this is in one Illustrator file. Now, if you work in Illustrator, this is definitely a good practice to have everything in one place, and then based on your artboards, you can create additional JPEGs, PNGs, PDFs, EPS files, what have you. The only problem with having lots of artboards, of course, is that the file gets bigger and it might take longer to zoom in and out because Illustrator slows down, but that's not the case anymore because CC 2019 version now is much faster in terms of zooming and navigation. Because what happens now is that when I start zooming, it automatically switches to a pixel version of my most previous or like recent view based on that, and when I let go, only then it refreshes it to the vector version. Same thing with the spacebar. If I pan around, it's going to be temporarily switching to a pixel view, which is not really getting in the way because I can still see what I want to get to, but once I let go, it refreshes and goes back into the vector version. So that's a very smart performance improvement, which I think is extremely useful, especially working with these big files. It is hard to demonstrate, but worth mentioning that linked files now are also loaded only once if there's multiple instances of the same file within one Illustrator document. So this again saves you time on opening Illustrator files with a lot of links inside them. Another really cool feature that we have in this new version is the actual size option. So from the view menu, when you select actual size or use Command or Control 1 to get to it, this will finally show you a real print size. So it's not going to always generate the preview based on 72 ppi. It knows your screen resolution and it will calculate the print size based on that. So this means that if I know the size of this print, I can put a paper on top of it and I can see it's almost exactly the same size. So it makes it much easier to see how big something is going to be in print. Another huge improvement is the GPU outline mode, which means that not only in the preview mode, but even in the outline view, which you can access from the view menu or Command or Control Y on the keyboard, now you still have the GPU performance improvement. So you are not going to rely on the CPU. Instead, Illustrator can generate these views very quickly and smoothly. So this is something that I love because I work in this view a lot and switch back and forth between preview and outline. And I hated the fact that only in the normal or preview mode, I had a smooth zoom and transitions, while in outline mode, it always slowed down and got sluggish. Now that's not the case anymore. You have consistent performance within these two views. So you can switch back and forth without issues. But what I love the most and I found extremely useful is this other new view option called presentation, which you can find from the view menu and switch to it. And in this mode, you can simply use left and right arrows on the keyboard to toggle through the artboards. And it's brilliant if you want to show something to a client and they are sitting there next to you, or you are sharing your screen and just want to quickly go through all the different variations, or even just to double check the differences between versions. You can see I'm switching back and forth using left and right arrows. And then when I'm ready, all I have to do is just to press escape. There's a shortcut as well to get to this view very quickly. That's Shift F. And it's definitely worth remembering and start using it. So if you're familiar with InDesign, this is exactly the same thing. There is Shift W, here is Shift F. And there's one last view in this new version that I love as well. It's called Trim View. If you go to the view menu again, you can find it in here. So Trim View. This feature finally gives us the option to see only what's within the artboard and hide everything else that goes beyond the outline of our artboard. And even the bleed will be hidden. So if you have bleed, that can be hidden away. So I can turn it on and off. And by the way, for this, there's no default shortcut, but you can customize it and set it up for one of the keys if you want to through the edit keyboard shortcut settings. But once again, this is a brilliant feature that will hide everything else that's outside of the outline of your artboard, including bleed and any additional information which could really get in the way when you want to show it to your client or when you just want to have a good look at your final result. So these might not seem that fancy new features, but believe me, for more professional users, these are really long-awaited features that finally now we have in Adobe Illustrator CC 2019. So thanks a lot for watching and join me next time where I will be showing you more about the new features in Photoshop, InDesign, and Illustrator.